position with me, is that correct? Great. I did have quite a few students apply this year, but you have made it to the interview process, which makes you the top 5% of that application process, so congratulations. Yes, I'm super excited that you're here, and here's how the interview will go. I have a few questions for you about why you're interested in this position, what you hope to gain from this position, that type of thing, and I'm also very curious about you as a person. Not that very many people want to work directly with me, and I'm always so mystified by the number of applicants I get. I know that my reputation in the literary community would benefit a great number of students here on campus with their long-term goals, but I'm not just some tool in a toolbox. I am someone who expects you to work hard in this position, and this is a mutually beneficial position. You'll be teaching classes, you'll be helping grade, you'll be doing any number of things to assist, okay? So this isn't just about you coming in and gleaning magical information from me, all right? Okay, just so we understand one another. Certainly. Excuse me. The rainy weather has been wreaking havoc on my sinuses, so you will have to excuse my sips of tea throughout our conversation. So, Chris, I was pulling up your academic record. Let me spell your last name again for me, Chris. That's correct. And you transferred here from community college last year, is that correct? That's very interesting. I've never had a candidate with your background before. Were you aware of that? You were. Okay, that's his name, Dr. Michael. a focused subject matter and not be overwhelmed. Dr. Franken was talking to me in an email about you. Yes, he mentioned that you have an ability to step outside of the subject matter in terms of not letting it negatively impact your ability to write a thorough and intriguing and very complete analysis of the work. He mentioned your work with some Holocaust studies and also your works with some of the depression literature. Interesting. I'm truly, truly intrigued by your interest in such subject matter. What brought you to being enthralled by this? Really? It wasn't that you lost at a young age your mother. Very sorry. How old were you? 5. My goodness. She'd been sick pretty much your whole childhood. I'm truly amazed with your resilience and ability to cope with that at such a young age. And your biological father passed 2 years later. Welcome to spend time. He's a very well-behaved, though based upon the university's expectations, not only to get on the tenure track, but to remain in your teaching position. For example, doctoral candidates have a requirement of 2 academic published papers in journals that are peer-reviewed per term and are required to have at least 1 major project published a year outside of peer-reviewed journals. And then once you become a doctorate on the faculty, but you're not tenured, you're working on your tenure track, the intensity of the requirements increases. Yes. Oh, you are aware of this university. Okay. And where is your desired university to work? Really? So, would you like to either stay here at this university in the United States, or you're looking at Germany or France? Do you have universities picked out there? That's very interesting. Why the one in Germany? I see. Okay, that's have you studied German? Oh, really? Okay. Is that something you kept up with outside of high school? Okay, interesting. Have you spoken to anyone in the German department here? Okay. Well, no matter how this interview goes, I will definitely email you a couple of professors that you should reach out to see if you can test through and claim that as a minor. You should always pursue whatever you can to increase your marketability, as they say. Let me email those to you now. Position. position if it was offered in terms of setting up a routine to work in this job. I know you also work in the campus library. You would have to cut that down to 2 days a week maximum. One, because of the maximum amount of pay that you can receive as a student worker, and two, just because of the workload that I have expectations for. But give me a little walkthrough of that, if you don't mind. No, not so much day to day, but just a generalized how you would plan out your week. And while you do so, forgive me for indulging in a snack. Would you like a Madeline? They're quite good. No. All right. Agreed. I think that many students do themselves quite a disservice by not taking the time to plan. Oh, that's interesting. Please continue. Really? I didn't read about that on your application. Oh no, I'm truly impressed. You did that as an undergrad at your community college. Really? Well, yes. I'm not going to lie and tell you that I'm not impressed. I truly am. Interesting. So, if offered the position, would you be willing to work over the summer session to help prepare for classes? Great. Great. I do have one question about that. Are you staying on campus for the summer? Let me check on that for you. Again. Well, I was Thank you.